الله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نوين الأربعين، نوين الاعتكاف، نوين الخلوة، نوين العزلة، نوين الرياضة، نوين السلوك، نوين الصيام لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد. ما الذي أولياء الله يعينون بعون الله ويكونوا عون لنا بالله سبحانه الله بفضل الله. أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم، طريقتنا الصحبة والخير في الجمعية. Our way is companionship. Coming together with good ones or whoever they designate on their behalf. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Today, depending what tawqeet, what which calendar you follow or which moon sighting you follow, but tonight will, after Maghrib, for some people it will be, for those at least in Arafah, in Hajj, it will be the night of Arafah beginning, one of the holiest, if not the holiest nights, days and nights of the year. And it has many fawaid, and I'm sure most of us have been over the benefits Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants His servants. But Arafah is, and the whole Hajj and its sha'air is not just for those who are going to Hajj. This time is very special time for the entire Ummah, and it's an opportunity for all of us. And it is a good manners to have your heart attached to that place, the holy place, and to attach to what it symbolizes, attached to the sha'air, what's happening also, what the Hujjaj are doing, to be at least with your heart there. And in Shafi'i Madhab, if you intend to sacrifice, we said it earlier in Jum'ah, it's recommended, it's sunnah to not to look after your physical appearance. It's sunnah not to cut your hair or your nails and so forth. It's an indication that at least with your tawajjuh, with you directing yourself to try to be there, to be connected to what is happening in Hajj. And if you can sacrifice, you should sacrifice. And if you can fast, you must fast. وَمَن يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. Those who give importance to the sha'air. Hajj is sha'ira. And in it there's tawaf, there's sa'i between Safa and Marwa, there's all these are sha'air. But whoever gives importance to that which Allah gives importance to, it is because of taqwa in the heart. And the entire Hajj has a very deep connection to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his family, his forefathers, and to come also, his progeny. And it has a very important, the whole sha'air of Hajj, whether it is sa'i or praying the two rakat sunnah behind the maqam of Sayyidina Ibrahim, the sacrifice based on the illustration, not story, of full submission and ubudiyyah of Sayyidina Ibrahim and his family. This is that holy family. The forefathers of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then culminating in the appearance of Sayyidina Muhammad, and after him his progeny. And they want us to, alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, to not give importance to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making a whole sha'ira in religion, one of the pillars of, based on what? Based on the sacrifice of Sayyidina Ibrahim, Sayyidina Ismail and Sayyidina Ibrahim. Based on the sacrifice, based on the anxiety and sacrifice of Sayyida Hajar. The sha'ira of Sa'i, we do Safa and Marwa, between Safa and Marwa we go Saba Ashwat. And one of the ulama was Rabbaniyin, was saying that if you look at Zamzam, it is from Sayyidina Ismail's kicking his feet in the ground that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought forth Zamzam. It was gushing forth, and it said, Sayyidina Hajar said, Zoom, Zoom. So that she was worried that it's going to flood. And then Sayyidina Hajar, with her feet also running between Safa and Marwa, that became a sha'ira. Now, all Muslims, whether you understand the hikmah or not, you go there, you have to do between Safa and Marwa. And you get to a point, you run as well. In emulation, in respect, in honoring of that lady's sacrifice, where her husband left her with her baby, newborn baby, in a barren place, no vegetation, no water, obeying his Lord, he left her there. And she submitted and accepted. All she wanted to know was if this is an order from Allah, then she was fine. But as a mother, seeing her son crying and thirsty, she was running between Safa and Marwa looking for something. And Allah made it until today. Every Hajj, every Umrah, people have to go and run between Safa and Marwa because of this. And then Sayyidina Ibrahim's maqam is where he stepped, his foot. We go there to pray. Allah is showing us the when his servants fully submit to him, and in ikhlas and sincerity, even the actions that they did with their feet becomes sha'ira. Sayyidina Ibrahim's foot sinking, till today people, you see, they want to touch it and they want to pray two rak'ahs behind where the holy foot of Sayyidina Ibrahim, the shape of the, where his foot sank in the rock. And Zamzam, from the kicking of the feet of Sayyidina Ismail, and Sa'i from the running of the feet of Sayyidina Hajar. Allah is showing us the importance of the prophetic family of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There are many sacrifices. Sayyidina Zakaria was sacrificed. Sayyidina Yahya was killed, was martyred. Sayyidina Isa, they tried to kill him and raised him. There are many occasions. Sayyidina Musa taking Bani Israel and splitting. يعني عيد الأضحى is about Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and his story and his lineage. And Ibn al-Dhabihain used to say, I'm the son of the two sacrificial sacrifices. And you see how the family of Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم extending to Sayyidina Ibrahim in that way and up till today is a family most honored in this creation as a family. This holy tree through which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught humanity to be servants. These are not stories. يا أبتي افعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. Do as you have been told, have been ordered. So we are coming upon this. It's important to think about and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these holy days to dress us with real ubudiyya, with real servanthood, not to object to anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we object even on small things in today's world. Why this? Why that? Why it's not happening like this? Why I have this? And Allah is showing you, highlighting this story of a father who waited for his son until old age, and then as soon as he becomes a young man, Allah says to him, go and sacrifice your son for me. But that full trust, that full acceptance of being owned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No objection. His son, no objection. He says, إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكَ. He say, he's taking him to sacrifice for Allah, and then there is no animal. And he was asking his father, you have the rope, but where's the animal we're sacrificing? He says, I'm seeing, Allah is showing me that I am, you are the sacrifice. He says, يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ. Do as you have been told. No, how could you do this? I'm a young man. Adam. It's really astonishing. The level of trust. Trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is, and then fast forward to Sayyidina Abdullah, who was also supposed to be sacrificed. Again, Ahlul Bayt. See how the whole place, the history of that place is the history of Ahlul Bayt. Who dug Bir Zamzam again? Bir Zamzam was covered. Then Sayyidina Abdul Muttalib, Sayyidina Abdul Muttalib saw a dream, and he showed him where it is, and he says to dig it. And then when they dug, they found a treasure. So Quraysh, they said, it is partnership. This is not just yours. It's for all of us. And he was, at that time, he didn't have children. So he couldn't resist them. At that time, if you don't have numbers, he made intention, if Allah gives him enough sons, 10 sons, that the last of them will be sacrificed, and that was Sayyidina Abdullah. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam twice, Allahu ghalibun ala amri, he's wasitatul wujud. He could be 100 times even if intended sacrifice, he's going to come into existence. صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه. So this is the story of Hajj is the story of the family of Prophet ﷺ, before and after. Even till today, Allah says that واستعيذ بالله اجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم. إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم يقيم الصلاة. That I have, O my Lord, in dua of Sayyidina Ibrahim, I am bringing my family to a place, a barren place, to establish, to pray, to worship you. عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ, at your holy house. And then Sayyidina Ibrahim said, اِجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ, that make the hearts attached and love, not to the bait, he didn't make for the haram. Tahwi ilayhim means to be attached to his progeny until judgment day. That is the dua of Sayyidina Ibrahim. And those who are lucky will find love and attachment to Ahlul Bayt. صلوات ربي وسلام على سيدنا محمد. One person asked about a practice, but she is not here, so we'll speak another time. She wanted to asking about muraqaba, observation, observing one's heart and state. It's a practice to be in to observe the state of your heart, what's in it. But in the Naqshbandi tariqa, I don't know about other tariqas, but in the Naqshbandi tariqa, it is not something that is done in the beginning, it is done in the end of the process, with the level of murids, until you have takhliya, until your heart is purified, and tazkiya and tahliya, then you may be ready to entrust yourself to understand what is occupying your heart and mind and state. But before that, it's not something our mashayikh in the beginning, they don't give that. They give you a wirt, and when you're ready, they may put you in khalwa. When you're ready, give you word of mubtadi or a word of murid. And I saw one time Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, they asked him about meditation and muraqabah. And he said that muraqabah is to be mustaghriq bil mahbub, to be completely in love with your Prophet ﷺ, with your Shaykh, who is your sila, who is the one teaching you and purifying you to be mu'ahal, to be connected to Sayyid al-Wujud. He says to be in complete love, that person, you become in hudur with that. You become in completely yani there's no room for anything to enter that heart except because it's full with love for Allah and His Prophet. That is one way, one meaning. Allah knows best. But what is essential for beginners on the path in the Naqshbandi tariqah, and all tariqas also, is the rabita. Rabita. The way the companions attained what they attained in the presence of Prophet ﷺ was because of their heart connection, rabita. And here in, there's, we're not going to speak about it another time in detail, but it is important that how they become Ashab al-Nabi. Prophet ﷺ, when they were sitting in his presence, they were in full stillness in his presence. Completely, even the description is, birds would mistake them for logs. Complete stillness. Because they were in rabita. He is sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reflecting the tajalliyat. He is the one like a mirror reflecting, and there in connection with him receiving those reflections. There is many hadith about Sayyidina Hamdallah's hadith about that nifaq, that when they are with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said nafaqa Hamdallah. When we are with you, when our hearts are connected to your hearts, they were seeing, they were experiencing, they were tasting in that rabita. So the rabita in tariqa is based on that rabita, because the nubuwa of Sayyidina Muhammad is until Judgment Day. And he said, ulama ummati ka anbiya ibn Israel, that the ulama al-rabbaniyin of the ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad are the inheritors, are like the prophets of Bani Israel, are inheriting from the prophets. So if you find one and you can be in rabita with that sheikh, with that murshid, if you can have a rabita between his heart and your heart, this is what is meant. Then you are able to receive from his heart what he is receiving from his mashayikh and his prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is the easiest way. Now they say, if you don't have a shaykh, have a wird of salah ala nabi, it will yani cover, but that wird has to be at least 1,000. Yani to be have that clarity, then you make 1,000 times Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad, if you don't have a shaykh. If you have a shaykh, 100, 300 will be enough. If you have a murshid, the beginner word is 100 salawat on Mondays and Thursdays, 300 salawat. It's enough. If you are in rabita with that shaykh, it's enough for the beginner, for tazkiyah. So rabita in Naqshbandi tariqah and in all tariqas is the most, one of the most important aspects of this. If you are not in rabita, you are with yourself. If you are with your sheikh through his heart, you are with the Prophet ﷺ. Because where is he? Where he is, where his rabita is to his sheikh, all the way to Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. So, and the rabita is something that the more you direct yourself, the more you believe. Because people don't believe now. You say rabita, you say, what is this? Hocus pocus. You say, iPhone? Rabita with iPhone is okay? Oh, iPhone, yes. Samsung, no problem. Rabita. I can make rabita with Samsung, no problem. I can see what's happening on the other side of the world also, automatically. But you say your heart, rabita with your murshid, what is this rabita? So it depends on your belief. How much belief do you have in what you are doing? Do you believe that you can direct yourself to the sheikh and you can be in connection with his heart? Yeah, you can. Even we say that when you make salawat on Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when you send him salam, he receives your salam. When we assalamu alayka ayyuhan nabi in our prayers, huh? For common people like us, we sit, we say assalamu alayka ayyuhan nabi, although we are talking to somebody. Alayka means you're in front of him. If there's nobody in front of you and you are talking about in the present, I'm saying assalamu alayka, and there's nobody in front of you. If other than the Prophet and the prayer, people will say, you mean somebody else, alayhi, alayhim, somewhere. There's nobody in front of you. Why are you saying salamu alayka? But when we say in Allah is teaching us, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching us in the prayer, you say salamu alayka ayyuhan nabi. If we don't see, it doesn't mean others don't see. It doesn't mean people of pure hearts, of real faith, they are not seeing when they're saying assalamu alayka. If we have that hijab, our mind here, our mind there, doesn't mean others don't. When you say awliyaullah, they see Prophet yaghdatan. They make so much salawat, they're in so much in connection, they're so much in ishq, in love, in fana, in istighraq, in annihilation with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that they see him ayanan bayanan. Yaqdatan, not in sleep, in dream, they see him. Don't say no. I haven't developed the tools myself, yes. But doesn't mean others haven't. So that's what is tariqah is to make us real servant. It's not about this. Tariqah is not about attaining this. But it's about becoming a servant. And this is now, this season, the Hajj season, is about being servant. The story of Sayyidina Ibrahim, Sayyidina Ismail, it's about being a full, believing, trusting, obedient servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We go through Eid, and we did the Udhiyah, and we do all this. But what is being taught in this Sha'ira? Is to be a servant, a real servant. Obedient servant. Allahumma marzuqna. Ya Rabb. Fi hadhihi al-ayam al-fadila. Inshallah, Allah grant us something from that reality, from that understanding, and grant us tawfiq to be also good servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And forgive our shortcomings, forgive our sins. Min Allahi tawfiq bi hurmati al-Fatiha.